Now, on this ship, previously, they had smoked salmon up in the garden buffet area, but now what they've economized by whipping up some kind of smoked salmon mousse on a cucumber, and now if you want smoked salmon, you gotta go to a restaurant.
Eggs Benedict. They have the secret for corned beef hash. Outstanding.
Well, here's my breakfast. I got two poached eggs, lots of fruit, and I brought this for coffee instead of the stupid 5-ounce cup. In my continuing effort to be healthier, I'm eating lunch, and I'm having, as you can see, a salad made with tandoori chicken, and the rest, fruit.
Notice the turmeric in this, very healthy. Ready for the lunch report for the C-Day? I'm gonna tell you, I had this, which was the Indian butter chicken with biryani rice and this other vegetarian dish that was fucking, it was delicious, really, really good. And this mess was reported to be a blue cheese hamburger, but really is a hockey puck. I don't understand how they can pass that off as a hamburger. I can't believe that. Why do they do Indian food in this ship better than hamburgers? I don't get it. Now, I'm gonna have to go on a quest and see if there's a real hamburger anywhere on this damn ship.
The best lunch that I had was at Arrecifes, a seafood place with a bar in Colon, Panama, right across from where our ship was docked. And I had time to wait and wait and wait to get on that ship, and I was gonna eat something really good seafood, and the langoustine cocktail was delicious with shrimp the size of prawns. They were delicious.
Cagney's was a lot like going to Outback or like Longhorn Steakhouse. Not quite the level of the Palm or Peter Luger. It was good, but not fantastic. You know, with your certified Angus beef. I had a steak. It was okay. The dessert was really good, though.
The macadamia nut ice cream was handmade. They were crisp on the outside, but tender on the inside, beautifully plated.
Well, I got myself a lovely two-top right here in front of a window. I don't know who the hell would order the whole roasted turkey sage and onion stuffing, except maybe my friend. Maybe my friend Steve would order that.
I don't know. Most of this stuff is just, you know, it's okay. The other stuff, it's not, that's really good. Of course, they charge extra for, which I already tried the lobster, which was, well, it was lobster. I mean, it was nothing special. Like, nothing here is special. It's just, you know, good. I guess it's okay.
I actually have a way to confession that I actually had like a taco and a burrito about an hour ago before dinner. Delicious.
Do you think they know how to mix a martini?
The best I can say is it's
faux ceviche. There is no leche de tigre with this. Zero.
This is more like more like shrimp salad. More like shrimp salad than ceviche.
I am proud to say that it's kind of hard to screw up a salad.
Chocoholic Night, which those of who know me as Mr. Chocoholic, well, guess what I'm having for my dessert tonight? I'm having one of everyone. Every damn, I'm gonna try every single one of these and I'm gonna love every last bit. I'm really excited. Everyone is a chocolate delight more than the one before. Oh my God. And this is some sort of apple thing.
As a jerk as I am, look, I'm absolutely the last one left in this whole damn place.
The last one. I'm telling you, it's not the first time either. I eat a lot, I guess, maybe. Now I'm going to Le Bistrot for a fancy French dinner.
Hello, how are you?
Fine, I'm very well. I'm hungry.
Hungry? You join us for dinner?
Yes, I am.
Yes, sir. Can I ask for your cabin number 9021, sir?
That's me.
Mr. Jerry. Sir Eric, you may follow me this way, please.
What did you just say?
This one, it comes with the salmon, capers, lemon juice, with the cream cheese, with the butter, French baguette.
Looks very nice.
Well, I can tell you that this place is... But the service is really excellent, attentive, and it's a nice room. It's a really nice room, and you know, I just think it's a little bit overpriced for what you're getting. I'll show you how the food really is. I mean, it's just had smoked salmon, like tartare. It's all right, you know. It's like we have on a bagel, you know.
Introduction to there. Escargot. Lamb chops. Well, actually, it's rack of lamb, but damn good. Damn good. This started off promising as with asparagus, and this is hollandaise. What else could be better than a bowl of delicious fruit, as long as it comes with
chocolate.
I Chinese. I like Chinese. They only come up to your knees, yet they're always friendly and they're ready to please. I like Chinese.
My very favorite table, thank you.
Yeah, I'll tell you about this particular seat. It is terrible because there's a confluence of sound from the teppanyaki, which is where the it's like a Benihana. It's a Benihana clone, you know, with a choppy suey kind of place, right? You know. Anyway, and then right down here.
All the many things they've done to impress.
Well, there's a nice little stage bar, so I don't get this noise.
I like Chinese. I like the Chinese people too.
I'm sorry, what?
Is one more person here join you?
Unless you are free.
Oh, very nice of you, sir. Maybe Kim. Are you taking video, sir?
Pardon?
Am I in a pillow?
Oh, no, I'm just by home by myself.
Oh.
Thank you.
So we've got here.
Like Chinese. Come up to your knee, yet they're wise and they're witty and they're ready to please. All together.
While I jump around, while I jump around, while I jump around, 你好吗? 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 再见. I like Chinese. I like Chinese.
It's pretty good.
So, sir,
I can't believe I'm on all this, but go ahead.
Okay.
What did I just order?
So, Sir Eric, have a calamari, wakame salad, hot and sour soup, lemon pepper shrimp, and seafood udon noodles.
You got
okay.
it.
Okay, thanks. Thank you.
All right, get right on it. I'm very
thank
hungry.
You, sir.
Wow, am I too.
I guess it just looks like a hot and sour soup.
Tame. I taste some sour, but not very much heat. Noodles.
Spicy seafood noodles. And your lemon pepper shrimp.
This, the udon noodles, is delicious. This broth is well done with plenty of heat. I can understand. I had a feeling that those red flakes going to be red chili, and they turned out to be really good. The wakame salad, well, you know, it's hard to screw that up. You just, you know, you grab a teaspoon of this stuff out of a bucket and throw it on another bucket full of shredded cabbage. I mean, what the hell? There's some kind of sweetness in this. It really has no place. Shrimp has no texture, or there's no contrast of texture that the stir frying was supposed to provide but fails to deliver. I got a feeling that panda salad came right out of a can,
because I'm really that interested in the desserts here. So I'm out.